Now we will see how exactly we obtain x of k from x of e raised to j omega. Development of DFT from DT of T. We know that the frequency domain representation of a discrete time signal obtained using discrete time Fourier transform will be continuous and periodic function of omega. With the periodicity of two pi. In order to obtain discrete function of omega, that means this continuous function of omega we want to convert into discrete function of omega. The DTFT can be sampled at sufficient number of frequency intervals . So this is all what we have discussed already. Let x of e raised to j omega be discrete time Fourier transform of the discrete time signal x of n . The discrete Fourier transform DFT of x of n is obtained by sampling one period of the discrete time Fourier transform. X of e raised to j omega at a finite number of frequency points . The frequency domain sampling is conventionally performed at n equally spaced frequency points in the period omega greater than or equal to 0 to less than or equal to 2 pi. The sampling frequency points are denoted as omega k. And they are given by omega k equal to, and they are given by omega k equal to two pi k upon n. For k equal to 0, 1, 2, dash, 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 n minus 1. Now the DFT is a sequence consisting of n samples of DTFT. Because we are dividing one period, that is 2 pi by n here. Therefore, DFT of discrete time signal x of n x of k is equal to x of e raised to j omega at omega equal to 2 pi k by n. Where k varies from 0 to n minus 1. generally the DFT is defined along with number of samples and is called endpoint DFT. The number of samples N for a finite duration sequence here means discrete time signal, that is x of n, of length L should be such that N is greater than or equal to L. In order to avoid aliasing of frequency spectrum. Here I assume that you all have studied aliasing effect in signals and systems. Let x of n equal to discrete time signal of length L. X of K be dft of x of n . Now this dft x of n is defined as . Now the dft of x of n with n points where n is greater than or equal to L. Is defined as x of k equal to summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi k n upon n. For k equal to 0, 1, 2, up to n minus 1. Symbolically, the n point DFT of x of n can be expressed as DFT of flower bracket x of n. Where DFT is the operator that represents discrete Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform. Therefore, we can write symbolically DFT of x of n as x of k that is equal to n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi k n upon n. For k equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. Since x of k is a sequence consisting of n complex numbers, why x of k is going to be complex number?
Because x of n is multiplied with e raised to minus j 2 pi k n upon n.
You learned that e raised to minus j theta is equal to cos theta minus j sin theta. So when you multiply real number x of n with complex number, you will be getting complex number only. Hence x of k is a sequence consisting of n complex numbers. For k equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. The d of t of x of n can be expressed as x of k equal to x of 0, x of 1 dash 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 x of n minus 1. After defining what is d of t, we must know what is the use of d of t. D of t gives us the frequency content of the signal x of n. What d of t gives us? D of t of x of n gives us the frequency content of signal x of n. That means how many frequency components are there and what is their magnitude, and phase angle of each frequency component. If we once come to know what is the frequency content of x of n, then we can design a digital filter to remove all unwanted frequency components from X of n. So these digital filters are there in your smartphones. They are there in Bluetooth headphones which have newly arrived in market. They are there in your smart television. And so on. See, DFT of X of N plays very, very important role to filter out any unwanted frequency component from the signal, which makes the signal, original signal, noisy. We have to design filter. It may be low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, or band rejection filter. But to design a filter, you must have the specifications. You must have the specifications. That means which frequency components are to be rejected and which frequency components are to be allowed to pass through the filter. So, to reject certain frequency components, you must know whether they are there in signal or not. For that, DFT is very, very important. Then you may get a question. Sir, how to find the magnitude of any frequency component? How to find the phase of any frequency component?
To these questions, we will have answers in next class.